that if I really liked him, then I would do it. And I told him that I really didn't care what his friends thought. I wasn't going to do that. I don't care what all the other girls are doing. That's just something I'm not going to do. I don't know. Wait. Do you hear something over there? What the hell is that?
I'm not sure. We should check it out.
What's the matter with you? Why are you here and why are you crying?
Oh, this is the worst day of my life. I can't believe anything that's happened. I went to the doctor and he has said I have some kind of virus and he can't fix me and I don't know what to do and my parents don't want me and I can't believe this is happening to me.
So here's what happened. I was walking along the road about 3 weeks ago when I was going to my grandmother's mausoleum. We have a family mausoleum, and my grandmother's been buried there for almost 10 years, and every year I like to go visit her on her birthday, because that's just what you're supposed to do, is have birthday parties with your family. And so everything was fine. It was a beautiful day until I went inside.
Ew, disgusting. Like, somebody needs to clean this up. Ugh. Oh my gosh, what's that? Ah! Ah! Oh my, I feel dizzy.
Oh, good Lord, child, you're still coughing after 3 weeks and you aren't getting any better. We are going to the doctor.
All right, Candace. What seems to be the problem today?
Well, I was visiting my grandmother's mausoleum about 3 weeks ago, and I'm not exactly sure what happened. I fainted, and something really strange has been happening ever since.
Strange things, huh? What kind of strange things?
Well, I'll show you.
I'm not sure about that. I'll have to go check WebMD. I'll be right back. Well, Candace, it seems that you have contracted a virus.
Uh-huh.
We've never seen this virus before, so unfortunately there's nothing we can do about it. You should go home and spend time with your family while you still can.
Good news, guys!
Hey, Dr. Smith.
Ooh, do tell!
Well, it appears I've just made the greatest scientific discovery of the decade! One of my patients was infected with a never-before-seen virus.
Ooh!
Which apparently
wow.
causes the skin to become transparent.
That's incredible.
Amazing!
We're gonna be rich.
Now, Pumpkin, I'm sorry. We got a call from Dr. Smith, and he said you could be contagious with that virus. And we can't have you around here with them other youngins. You're gonna have to leave.
Yesterday, all my troubles seemed so far away. Now it looks as though they're here to stay. Oh, I believe in yesterday.
So that's my story, and that's why I'm here.
Well, you can't just sit here and wait to die. Just come with us.
Well, I guess I could do that. Okay. No, wait. I can't. There's something not right. Something's wrong. I don't feel right. I have to go. I don't want to hurt you. Just leave me alone.
Well, where do you think she's run off to?
I don't know. I guess maybe we should follow her. Oh my God, is that her?
Stand back, Liz. You don't need to be afraid, because I've been training for this moment for my entire life.
So, Marth, was there something you wanted to maybe tell
me? Liz, you know I'd love to tell you, but then I'd have to kill you.
Okay, so on to a different subject then. That was awesome. So, Marth, you want to go get a burrito?
It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. It's the end of the world as we know it. I feel fine. I feel fine. Lester Banks, birthday party, cheesecake, jelly bean, boom, you symbiotic, patriotic, slam, button, nap, right? It's the end of the world as we know it.